Stanley Miller was widely regarded as the father of prebiotic chemistry, a pioneer in the abiotic synthesis of organic molecules important for life. And he did a very famous experiment where he published in 1953. He showed that you can form simple organic molecules important for life using very simple starting materials that represented the early Earth. The spark represents lightning. So the idea was to simulate a primitive ocean atmosphere system. So the liquid water was put in there to represent the early Earth's oceans, and the gases, methane and ammonia, were introduced to represent what they thought was an accurate portrayal of the early Earth's atmosphere. And then the spark represented a lightning discharge, which is a form of energy that was probably very common on the early Earth. Now, when Miller retired, he gave all of his laboratory possessions to Geoffrey Beta. And so Jeff inherited these samples, and these samples were later discovered in 2007. Hundreds of samples that had, many of which had never been analyzed, including some of these samples that we're reporting on in this most recent paper. Well, what we found is something very exciting. We found that not only can you form amino acids, which is something that Miller had shown in his 1953 work, but by introducing this external molecule called cyanamide, you can cause these amino acids to link together and form larger compounds called peptides. And in the order of the evolution of organic chemicals, you have a progression from amino acids to peptides and ultimately to things like proteins. And so this is a next step, something that addresses one of the major challenges that remains in prebiotic chemistry, which is how do you go from making small molecules like amino acids to larger, more complex compounds like peptides? It's ultimately about the origins of life, and this is a process along that pathway, is trying to understand how chemicals evolved on the early Earth to ultimately give rise to the first forms of organisms on the Earth.